Supreme Court holds hearing to determine disqualification period of lawmakers under Article 62. Supreme Court on Tuesday conducted a hearing regarding the interpretation of Article 62(1)(f) of the Constitution with a view to ascertaining the period of disqualification of a Member of Parliament. A five-judge Supreme Court bench comprising Chief Justice Mia Saqib Nisar, Justice Sheikh Azmat Saeed, Justice Umar Atta Bandial, Justice Ijaz ul Ehsan, and Justice Sajjad Ali Shah has taken up a set of 17 appeals against disqualification of lawmakers. During the hearing, the Chief Justice said that the court will give a one-sided judgment if any of the lawmakers affected by Article 62 fail to appear in court. The Apex Court had issued notices to former Prime Minister Nawaz Sharif and former Tehreek-e-Insaf Secretary General Jahangir Tareen to appear in person or through their counsel during the hearing of the appeals involving the interpretation of Article 62(1)(f), the provision under which both had been disqualified. Accountability Court reserves verdict in Evanfield reference against Sharifs. An accountability court in Islamabad on Tuesday reserved its verdict in the Evanfield Flats reference, one of the three that had been filed against members of the Sharif family by the National Accountability Bureau in the wake of the Supreme Court's Panama Papers order. Accountability Court Judge Mohammad Bashir reserved the verdict after hearing arguments presented by the NAB Prosecutor General and lawyer of the former Prime Minister Nawaz Sharif. Dr. Asim reappointed Sindh Higher Education Commission Chairman. Sindh government has reappointed Pakistan People's Party leader Dr. Asim Hussain as Chairman of Sindh Higher Education Commission for another term. The notification for his reappointment was issued on January 26 by the Services, General Administration and Coordination Department of the Sindh government. It said, in continuation of his department's notification of even number dated 28 January 2014, an exercise of the powers conferred under Sections 5(1) of the Sindh Higher Education Commission Act 2013, the Chief Minister Sindh Controlling Authority is pleased to reappoint Dr. Asim as Chairperson, Sindh Higher Education Commission for one more similar term. Netanyahu raises Iran's role in Syria with Putin. Israeli Prime Minister Benjamin Netanyahu visited Russia on Monday for talks focused on Syria, reaffirming Israel's opposition to Iran's growing military presence there and in neighboring Lebanon. Before departure for talks with Russian President Vladimir Putin, Netanyahu said that Iran is trying to turn Lebanon into one giant missile site, a site for precision missiles against the State of Israel, which we will not tolerate. Turkey presses ahead with the Afrin offensive. Hundreds of people attended funerals on Monday for casualties of a Turkish offensive against Kurdish forces in the Syrian border region of Afrin. New civilian casualties were reported following the latest clashes and airstrikes in the operation launched by Turkey and Syrian opposition fighters against Kurdish militia in northwestern Syria. House of Lords to look at Brexit devolution concerns. Members of the House of Lords are expected to recommend changes to EU withdrawal bill, which moves to its second reading later. Scotland's Brexit Minister Michael Russell has briefed peers on concerns his government has about the implications for devolved government. He has claimed the bill disregards the devolution settlement. The UK government has said it will continue with detailed discussion to address these concerns. No detailed changes can be made to legislation in the House of Lords at second reading, but amendments can be made at a later stage. CIA Chief Mike Pompeo says, China as big a threat to United States as Russia. Chinese efforts to exert covert influence over the West are just as concerning as Russian subversion, the director of the CIA said. Mike Pompeo told that the Chinese have a much bigger footprint to carry out such covert activities than the Russians do. He also said he expected Russia to target the 2018 U.S. midterm elections. The U.S. intelligence community has said that it believes Russia interfered in the 2016 presidential election. Tank battle rocks Yemen's coup hit Aden. At least 36 people have been killed and 185 wounded in 2 days of heavy fighting between separatists and government troops in Yemen's interim capital of Aden, the Red Cross said Monday. Heavy fighting intensified at night after the two sides used tank and artillery on the second day of an attempted coup in Aden, military sources said. As the fighting escalated, the Saudi-led military coalition, which supports the government, called for dialogue and for it to hear the demands of the separatists in the southern port city. India brush aside Pakistan in Under-19 World Cup semi-final. India crushed arch-rivals Pakistan by 203 runs in their Under-19 World Cup semi-final in Christchurch Tuesday to set up a tournament decider against Australia. An unbeaten century from Shubman Gill helped India set a competitive total of 270, which Pakistan never looked like reaching as they were skittled for 69 and more than 20 overs remaining. It was the Pakistan youth team's third lowest total on record, underlying the battling woes of a team that failed to score more than 200 during the tournament in New Zealand. Weather. Weather forecast for next 24 hours. Rain, thunderstorm with light snowfall over the hills is expected at scattered places in Malakand, Hazara, Peshawar, Quetta, Zob divisions, Fata, Kashmir and Gilgit-Baltistan, while at isolated places in Bannu, Kohat, Mardan, Rawalpindi, Gujranwala, Sargodha divisions and Islamabad. Foggy conditions are likely to prevail in plain areas of Punjab and Upper Sindh during night and morning hours.
Please subscribe to Hums Up TV and hit the notification icon on the screen to get the latest updates of our channel. Thank you for watching Hums Up TV.